So if you're watching this video, there's a chance that you are looking to organize your online business. Maybe you're just starting out, you're not sure where to begin, and you want to make sure you set your business up for success. Maybe you are growing your business and you're like, oh my gosh, if I don't have this in place, it's going to be very difficult in the future. Or maybe you're like me and you grew your business so fast that all of a sudden you were like, this is not sustainable. We have to come up with a better system and plan. No matter what position you are in, I'm here to help. This is what we're going to talk about for today. We're going to talk about how to organize your online business. I'm Nicole. I'm the owner of AIM Social. We are a social media marketing virtual assistance agency that have worked with over 80 different clients across the world. And we have global team members as well. So we're really excited to share everything that we do to stay organized with our agency with you. So the first thing I want to talk about is having a system for your customers. So as you grow and you get more and more customers, it's really great. But one of the things you're going to need to do is stay organized within that. So the first thing that I would have you do is get a CRM or a clear system in place. We have a CRM that we include all of our clients' names, all their business information, their emails, their addresses, so we can send them brownies and cards on holidays. We include all of that information and keep track of that, so we have one place for it. The next thing that we do is we have a Google Drive for each and every single one of our clients that holds their contracts in there, but all their assets and any other information that we have for them, we have all within their drive, so it's easy to find. We also have a Trello board for each client that has set up, which we're going to talk about in just a second on how we use that. But each client has that, and we use Slack for all of our communications with our clients and with our team. So we have little channels for each client, so that way their entire team can communicate with the client easily. Client can get a hold of whoever they're looking for. And so they have that ability. So we do that as well. All right, so let's jump over to the next section, which is planning your social media in advance. As much as posting every day and just doing it manually seems really great, chances are you're going to forget, or you're going to get really busy and it's going to go to the back burner. If you're an online marketer, chances are you probably experience that and then low-key shame about it, because that's what you do. You should know how to do it, right? So if you're in the same boat as me and every other social media manager, virtual assistant, online marketer, chances are we've been there, you've been there, and this is how we overcome it. So the one thing that we do is we have Trello set up for every single client and for ourselves. In that, we have broken down each day of the week and what we're going to post. And then in there, we build out a whole month's worth of content. And we try to make sure that we have at least 2 weeks worth of content every single week going out, so that way we're always ahead. We have all the content created, all the captions, all the hashtags, all the graphics. And then we have all of the communication within there and everything too, for anybody that needs to make changes. And then we just have somebody go through and schedule it all. Keeps it nice, clean, organized, and streamlined. If you want to see our behind the scenes system and everything else, there is a link down below. You can grab that and learn more about how to do that. I'd love to give you access to that. All right, the next thing that I would recommend you do is organize your passwords. So we use LastPass for our business, for our team, and for our clients. This makes it a really great way for our clients to set their passwords to us, so that way we can access things without necessarily having access to their password. So when they offboard, they don't have to change all their passwords. So this is really great. But even if they do send us their passwords manually, instead of having to go back and look through the chats and be like, oh my gosh, what was their password? We have it all in LastPass. We add it there. And so it's really easy to share with the whole team, as well as keep track of it. So if a team member asks for a password, I can just look in LastPass and find it instead of searching through previous communications trying to find it. So that is a great way to stay organized there. Next, I want to talk about improving your workspace for increased productivity. So there's a few things that I did as I grew my office. It's still not my favorite dream office, but we're getting there. A few things that I have is I have a clear space in front of me with my computer. I have the ring light and everything else behind the scenes, but I also have a standing desk. So on the days that I need to be a little bit more animated, or I just need to be standing to get a little bit more energy, I can do that easily enough. I can do that on calls or whether I'm just working. So I invested in a standing desk, which was really great. We also have bookshelves. You can't see them, but bookshelves here, where everything is organized. So that way we don't have a lot of extra things going on in piles of papers and books and everything else. So everything has a place and it's organized. We have filing cabinets and everything for any papers that need to be put away, but we try to keep everything nice and clean and clear so that way you can go in with a clear mind. When things are cluttered, usually so is your brain. So we try to make sure that that stays organized. Within that mindset, we also try to make sure that our computer's desktop stays organized. So one of the things we do is we literally only have a handful of things on our desktop. And we will go through that regularly and delete anything that doesn't need to be there. The reason why we do this is because you want a nice, clear, open space when you start your day, when you log in, and it doesn't get overwhelming. You're not trying to struggle to find where things are. Having a place for everything is super important. Saving everything in your drive so that way it's easily searchable to find. Literally, as I sat down to record this video, I was like, oh my gosh, I know I have a script somewhere for this video. Where is it? Searched in my Google Drive, found it easily enough. So everything has a place and then it's easy to find going forward. All right, the next thing I want you to do is track your time effectively. Now, if you're a virtual assistant, you work hourly, then chances are you're already familiar with doing that. We use Toggle for our internal tracking. You can use whatever system your clients request or that you use for your business, but you track your time, obviously. If you work monthly retainers or within a retainer, you don't necessarily have to track your hours. It's still really important to track your time to be able to see how you're performing. Are you actually making money or are you losing it? It's interesting to see how long sometimes things take us and we think, oh, it'll only take me an hour, but actually it takes 3 hours. Oh my gosh, if you're charging what you think in your head is only going to take an hour, but you're spending 3 hours, aren't you losing money then? It might be time to raise your rates or look at how can we be more efficient in the opportunity that you're doing. So looking at that, one of the things we love to do is a time study. So we sit down and we record every 15 minutes. What did we do in the last 15 minutes? And it's really great to see where you're spending a lot of your time. Are you streaming on TikTok and not actually doing your work? That is a good opportunity to be like, maybe I should set a specific time or a specific amount of time that I'm allowed to do that so I'm not wasting all my day. Not that streaming on TikTok is a waste of time, but maybe not necessarily where you need to be spending your time in that moment. So same with scrolling Facebook or Instagram or watching Reels or TikToks or all the things. It's so easy to get caught up in that. You don't realize how much time you've actually spent doing other things instead of doing your work. So a time study is really amazing and effective. And then the last thing I want to talk about, I mean, there's tons of things we can talk about, but the last thing I want to talk about is your email inbox. If you were like me and almost every other person that works online, you chances are your inbox has gotten a little bit intense. So one of the things we like to do is go through and we literally have a second email address for all our newsletters because you know what? Getting newsletters sometimes is fun. So we literally have an email that we can go in and look at all the newsletters and get all the information, that sort of thing. However, our main inbox is kept specifically for certain things. So for our internal, and this doesn't have to be the same for you, but for our internal, we don't use emails for our clients. Everything goes through Slack. So the only emails that we get from people are people that want to work with us or their internal things like Trello notifications or messages that were sent on other platforms when we get a reminder. So we have those set up so that way it's easy to figure out what needs to be done for the day and prioritize. If you have everything going to one email, you have all your newsletters and all your client communication and everything else, chances are you're going to miss things, important things like invoices to pay your subcontractors or payments that need to be accepted. You will miss a lot of things because you're overwhelmed and because you don't have a clear system. So I would recommend you get those in place. So those are my top tips for keeping your business organized. If you have additional things that you'd like to add, drop them below. I'd love to hear more from you. And if you want more information along this lines, I have a fantastic resource coming up for you. You can drop a comment down below or check the links in the bio to see what we have in store. Awesome. Have a fantastic day, you guys. We'll see you later.
Oh, am I getting it? Am I not getting it? I don't know. Now I have to call you, and I don't want to talk to people. That was why I did it online, guys.